Welcome back. Here in this video, we'll be discussing on the pseudosilomate phylum. We have already seen Actinomythus and Nematoda under the pseudosilomate phyla. Here we are going to discuss on the minor phyla under the pseudosilomate group. And there are two phyla which has to be studied. One is phylum Gastrotrycha with an example Chitonate notus, and phylum Rotifera with the example Brachyonus. Okay. So here we'll discuss on phylum Rotifera. Phylum Rotifera, actually the name comes from two Greek terms. Rota means wheel and ferre means to bear. They are commonly referred as wheel animal cues, and because of their structural features, peculiar movement, and similar to the rotation of a wheel, they are referred as wheel animal cue. Okay. They are provided with cilia, and with the cilia and they bring about the movement, and this movement is almost similar to the rotation of the wheel. Right. They include microscopic animals which are found in ponds, lakes and streams, that is freshwater aquatic habitats. And they are found actively swimming in these freshwater habitats. Very rarely we can find them in marine ecosystem, for example seas. And most rotifers, they are benthic forms. Benthic forms in the sense they are found along towards the bottom of the aquatic habitats. But very few we can find planktonic groups as well. Rotifers are relatively short living. Their lifespan usually range from a few days to a few weeks, not more than that. But still, they have a very great ability to withstand desiccation. That is, when in freshwater habitat, during the extreme dry conditions, obviously the water may get dried off. So even during those conditions, environmental conditions, it is found that rotifers can survive. Okay. Now, what are the other characters regarding the phylum Rotifera? They are bilaterally symmetrical, unsegmented. As already mentioned, they are pseudocoelomate metazoans. They have, we can see here, head region, it is, the head region, it is broad with a central disc. It is somewhat like this. Okay, I'll try to draw the figure. Okay, so the head region, it is somewhat very broad. Okay. It's not getting uniform. Okay, it is almost uniform around this one. Okay. So this area, it is known as the apical field. Okay, it is known as the apical field. It is broad and it is the anterior part, that is the we can say mouth bearing part. And this apical field, this is the apical field, and this part is encircled by a ciliary zone or ciliary tract. Okay, and this ciliary tract is what is referred as the corona. Okay, it is a ciliary disc. So we can see that the head region, it is broad with non-ciliated region, part. It is known as the apical disc, and surrounding that there is a ciliary region which is known as the corona. Okay, and that is also referred as a wheel organ, and it is used for feeding and locomotion. So it is actually because of that wheel organ, it gets the name Rotifera. Okay, so this particular structure, what we call the corona, it distinguishes phylum Rotifera from every other pseudocoelomate group, even other metazoans. And corona may be subdivided into retractile, locomotor and food collecting disc, which are known as trochal disc. And this we'll be learning when we discuss the example, okay, Brachyonus in detail, right? So far we have seen that they do have head region, do have an apical disc which is free of any cilia, and surrounding that is a ciliary disc which is known as a corona. Okay. Now, the body wall, actually the body is provided with a cuticle. Our body wall is thickened by, is provided with a covering which is a cuticle, and this cuticle is formed of glycoprotein. The cuticular covering, it becomes hard and thick, and it becomes a case which is referred as the larica. Okay, so body wall becomes sometimes it becomes thickened into stiff plates, which is referred as a larica. And this rotifers may be divided into two groups based upon the presence or the absence of larica. Those rotifers with larica or with the thickening and thickened body wall is referred as loricates, and those without larica they are known as elaricates. Okay, and it is found that in those with larica, the head usually may retreat inside into the larica. So that is about another unique feature of rotifers. Right. Then we can see, already mentioned, it is pseudocoelomate. So they do have a very spacious pseudocoel, the perivisceral cavity. Okay. Then digestive system, it is with a grinding organ. Yes. So digestive system, it is provided with a very massive, very unique pharynx, which is modified to form a grinding structure, which is known as the mastax. Or we can say masticating structure, which is known as the mastax. Okay. And this mastax, it is provided with a dental mill, which is composed of hard and jaw-like cuticular structures. So, mastax and these cuticular structures, they are characteristics of rotifers. So, we have already seen larica, the presence of larica is a feature of rotifera. Then, corona, it is very unique to phylum rotifera, which is not found in any other metazoans. And then, the pharynx being modified to form the mastax, and the mastax provided with a cuticular structures which are known as trophi. This we will be learning when we discuss the mastax in the case of Brachyonyx. We will be seeing this figure as well. So, mastax and trophi, that is also unique to rotifer. Okay. So, these are the characters of what we can say rotifera. We have already seen it is common in freshwater, terrestrial. They play a very important role in nutrient cycling, in the sense that they have a very important ecological role as for, as a part of the aquatic ecosystem. Then, regarding its reproduction, sexes are separate and sexual dimorphism is very distinct, because males are like smaller than females, and we can see males, they are almost degenerate. That is, they don't have much of the very elaborate systems, organ systems inside. Okay. And another feature we can see is that sexual mode of reproduction is found. At the same time, parthenogenesis is also found in rotifers. Another important feature is that many of the rotifers do have the ability of cryptomorphosis. Cryptobiosis and cyclomorphosis. Okay, they do have the this one of cyclomorphosis. So what is cyclomorphosis? Cyclomorphosis is actually the seasonal change in the form, shape, proportion of the body. Cyclomorphosis, that is cyclic change of morphological features. What is the base upon that? That is actually based upon the season. Okay, so rotifers, they undergo seasonal changes in the morphological features. It could be the form, the shape, the proportion of the body, and that particular phenomenon is known as the cyclomorphosis. And you can see when that is during one season, individuals may be longer or shorter or have shorter spines than those developed during another season. So such kind of morphological features can be found in the members of the same species but developed in different seasons seen in different seasons. That is a cyclomorphosis. Okay. Then example, Phylogena and Brachyonyx. Apart from that, they also show a phenomenon known as cryptobiosis. Crypto means hidden, bios means life, isn't it? So cryptobiosis means the whole life processes may get suspended, almost stopped. Okay, and at particular stage in rotifers, and it almost seem like it is almost dead. Okay, so it doesn't show any of the life processes. So what happens is it seems to be like a dead inanimate object, and this actually help in tiding over extreme environmental conditions or unfavorable environmental conditions. So that kind of a phenomenon is known as cryptobiosis. Okay, so these are the two phenomena these are shown by rotifers, that is cyclomorphosis and cryptobiosis. Okay, now these are, I mean, the Phalaenoptera, it includes two taxa, that is Monogonota and Deloidea. Deloids, males are altogether absent and reproduction is completely parthenogenetic. And in monogonotes, males are very rare and present only during restricted times of the year. Okay, so monogonota, they are those groups which are represented, which have males, but they are very rare, and males are found only during a particular time of the year. While deloids, males are completely absent and reproduction is mainly by parthenogenesis. So these are a few general features of phyla, Rotifera.